The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Charlie died and rose to life with Christ. May he now share with the risen Christ eternal glory.
I go before Before we begin the celebration of the funeral mass, we place on Charlie's coffin the Christian symbols. First of all, we place a book of the scriptures. The church invites us to turn to the word of God for a word of consolation and hope. And as we place the book of the scriptures on Charlie's coffin, we pray that the Lord might greet him with the words of eternal life, "Come, blessed of my Father." We also place on Charlie's coffin the crucifix. The crucifix is a symbol of suffering and death. But with the eyes of Christian faith this morning, we see in the crucifix the sign of Christ's victory over suffering and death. And we pray that Charlie will share in that victory.
Thank you, Father Declan, and welcome to everybody who have come today. Please be seated. So we gather Charlie's family, his wife Mary, Aisling, Cathal, his sister Rose, his brothers Michael, Tommy, Frankie, Mattie, Paul, Johnny, Declan and Noel, mother-in-law Evelyn, in-laws, nieces, nephews, grandnieces, grandnephews, relatives and many, many friends. So as we place the Christian symbols on the coffin, we now place, or we bring up also other symbols of Charlie's life. So I think Cathal is going to tell us what they are, and Mattie, Jane, Stephen, Martin, Michelle, Dennis, Tom and Niall will bring them forward. They're down at the back.
As Dad would say, if you're not laughing, you're crying. So please feel free to have a laugh. Dad's brother Mattie brings up his Meath jersey from the 1990 All-Ireland final. This represents Dad's love for sport. Both he and Mam followed Meath everywhere in the 80s and 90s when Meath were going well. Dad would also say that he taught Mattie everything he knows about football. Jane brings up his set of rings. He threw rings when he was young and rediscovered his love for the game in recent years when he threw for the Lacken. Even during COVID, we managed to get a few games in online when Mam eventually gave us permission to put the board in the back hall. Stephen brings up our granddad's pitch and putt clubs, representing his love for pitch and putt and golf. As good as Stephen thinks he is, I don't think he's still got the better of Dad. Martin brings up a lotto ticket, representing Dad's organisation skills at work. I think for some of the Heat Merchants lads here, you owe him a few pounds still. Michelle brings up a watch, showing his love for these. Dad could go into TK Maxx on any day, buy two or three watches at a time, and never wear any of them. Dennis brings up a booklet from the old graveyard in Rakenny. This represents his sense of community and working hard and making friends. Tom brings up his favourite tractor, representing his love for farming and the land. Many a conversation Dad had with Tom below Mayo about what's happening on the farm. Niall brings up a tool. This represents Dad's love for fixing things, whether it was a washing machine, a lawnmower, a shower, a leaking pipe or a broken chair. Who are you going to call? Not Ghostbusters, call Charlie.
So we bring all these symbols, symbols of Charlie's life, symbols of his faith. And as we gather today, we entrust Charlie to God's everlasting care. We're thankful for what he has meant to us, the person he has been, the service he has offered, the contribution he has made to many lives. We're thankful for what Charlie means to his family, colleagues and friends, for what he will continue to mean to us into the future, for Charlie's achievements, the ones that we look back on with pride, challenges faced, successes won, potential fulfilled. We're thankful for the experiences, happy and sad, that we've been through together, the love and friendship and faith we have shared, the qualities and characteristics that make Charlie special to us. We're thankful for his faith, his commitment to Christ and this community, faithful discipleship and personal experience of God's love, for the memories we will always have as a lasting tribute and enduring legacy. We come together today in hope and confidence, trusting in God's promise, assured of God's continued purpose. In that faith, we entrust Charlie and ourselves into God's gracious keeping now and for all eternity. As we come together in love, compassion, care, for the times we have offended God or each other, we ask for pardon and forgiveness and have hope in God's love and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us all one day to everlasting life. And let us pray. Eternal God, you made the union of man and woman a sign of the bond between Christ and his church. Grant peace and mercy to Charlie, who was united in love with Mary. May the care and devotion of his life on earth find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on Mary and his family as they now turn to your compassion and love. Strengthen their faith, lighten their loss. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So now we listen to the readings.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them, a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
Shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green. He leadeth me the quiet waters by. My soul
sake.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. If we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be Lord both of the dead and the living. We should all have to stand before the judgment seat of God, and the scripture says, "Be my life, it is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall praise God." It is to God, therefore, that each of us must give an account of himself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. I tell you most solemnly, unless a wheat grain falls on the ground and dies, it remains only a single grain. But if it dies, it yields a rich harvest. Anyone who loves his life loses it. Anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a man serves me, he must follow me. Wherever I am, my servant will be there too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. If you have a seat for a few moments, well, maybe a few more than that, but just to reflect today on Charlie and his life, and indeed ourselves as we gather in sadness during these days, because we can't help but notice the evenings getting longer, darker, and just a reflection first talks about the seasons of life. Nothing so marks the passing of time as does the passing of seasons. We have seasons in our own lives too. In the springtime of our lives, we have a sense of things beginning, of life awakening. We emerge from our shells full of life and energy, brimming with hopes and dreams. Life stretches out endlessly before us. Anything seems possible. Spring quickly leads to summer. Our plans have been trimmed down to more realistic proportions. But things are progressing nicely. Life is full, life is joyous. There aren't enough hours in the long day to do all that we want to do. Alas, all too soon, summer gives way to autumn. Our energy begins to wane and life slows down. There is joy, however, because we reap the fruits of what we had sown. But there's sadness too, because regrets come home to roost and opportunities that we didn't take. The fleetingness of life strikes us with full force. How quickly life's stream runs to the sea. And finally, autumn surrenders to winter. Now our lives are cold and empty. We are stripped bare. It seems that life has stopped. We are not really living, only enduring, just hanging in there. And death is like that sense of winter, only worse. Nature's winter, despite appearances to the contrary, life doesn't cease. It goes underground. The outward dies, but not the core. In the winter of death, it seems to cease altogether. Death seems to rob us of everything, especially if it comes maybe prematurely, depriving a person of one of the seasons of their life. When winter came in the scriptures for Lazarus and his sisters Martha and Mary, they were plunged naturally into gloom. But Jesus said to them, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, they will live." This is one of the most consoling statements in the gospel. It tells us that Christ holds the key to life and death. though he himself experienced the winter of death, by rising from the dead, he broke the power of death forever. A new and invincible spring has dawned on him and on all who believe in him. So we think today of Charlie and his life. Born on the 1st of July in 1960 in Beauparc, makes him 62 years old. He went to Yellow Furze School and the vocational school in Navan. He worked from an early age, Colin Brennan, Frank Heslin, Peter Scanlon and Navan Carpets, till he spent 25 years in Heath Merchants in Navan. Charlie was very good with his hands and learned things quickly. He made many friends in each of these places and was a trusted friend and advisor. He played Gaelic football at junior and senior level for Senchilstown and followed the Meath team at Mary all over the country. He also followed Ratkenny after he had come to live here. He had a great interest and knowledge of the game and how it could and maybe should be played. And he discussed GA matters on a Sunday with his brother Frank and others long after Mass was over. He was very proud of his brother Mattie's achievements with the Meath team and his son Cathal's playing with Ratkenny. He married Mary on the 23rd of September 1987 here in this church. They were very united and provided for Cathal and Aisling. He was always proud of their achievements and drew great strength from their bond and their love they shared in their family unit. He was very united with Evelyn, his mother-in-law, his brothers-in-law, Joseph and Eamonn, and Eamonn's death recently shook him. He was very united to his own eight brothers and one sister and their families. As I said, he was everyone's godfather, a go-to person who was there where troubles were needed, when there was fixing things, but also a listening ear that helped also to mend broken hearts. Fixing things gave him great interest. I'm sure he felt he improved things. Rebuilding an old motorcycle one time, he found that it still ran, even though he still had a number of parts still in his hands. So I'm sure he felt he had improved it. GA was his great interest, but also, as we saw there earlier, darts and rings provided a good social life. He enjoyed and played pitch and putt and followed the golf going to Dubai as part of the race to Dubai. He had a great interest in local history. He was a founder member of the committee formed to restore the old cemetery in Ratkenny. One of his final tasks before he went to the hospital recently was to cut the grass. Charlie has been ill with cancer for the past 2 years, and he lived that roller coaster of chemo and tests, fear and hope. He deeply appreciated the care of his family and friends, especially Aisling, who helped him with his medication, but all who cared for him in hospital and all who supported him. He appreciated visits and calls from family and friends, and indeed, COVID added to the challenge and uncertainty in recent times. He'd received challenging news recently, was carrying on bravely, and was facing it when death came quickly to him last Monday morning. We are glad of Charlie's life. We wished it was longer, but we appreciate his goodness and friendship, good humour and wit, his talent for fixing hearts and things. We feel sad that he will miss some of the milestones yet to be reached in his family's life. But we carry the memory of his smile, his values and commitment, his belief and confidence in us, the wisdom he shared with us over many years. In the midst of the sadness and uncertainty of our country, and indeed our world at this time, we hold on to this sense of commitment, his belief and faith, his hope, and ultimately the love that we shared. It's the readings we had. I suppose that first reading is a catch-all reading, reminds us. Today we weep and mourn, but we remember today also, and we have done over these past days, the times when we laughed and danced, the times when Charlie built us up, the things he mended, the times we embrace. Now we face a time of loss and death, but we embrace each other in love and support. The influence of Charlie has been obvious over these days of the many who visited the house, but also many who are with us here today. The gospel reminds us again of that sense of that reflection of the passing of time, the circle of life and death. And our hope, I suppose that what breaks that chain a little bit is our hope in resurrection and new life for Charlie and for ourselves. So now we might have our prayers of the faithful, please. So that's Emma, Harry, Mark, Kayla, Kira, Katrina, Tara, and Helena. We bring our prayers with confidence to God, who is our shepherd and the guardian of our souls.
Charlie touched all our lives. Help us to keep alive the values and the ideals he put before us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, pray hear us.
God of all consolation, help us in our grief to comfort one another. May we find light in time of darkness and faith in times of doubt. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the family and friends of Charlie. In these difficult days, may the Lord be their strength and their consolation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray in thanksgiving for all the blessings that came to so many people through the life of Charlie. May he now receive the fullness of God's blessings in eternity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all our departed brothers and sisters. Today we pray for Charlie's parents, Michael and Detta, his sister Kathleen, his niece Deirdre, his nephew Ciaran, his father-in-law Eddie, and his brother-in-law Eamonn. May Charlie be reunited with them in God's kingdom, where there is no more pain or suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We ask the Lord's blessing on all those who are seriously ill. Be close to them in their time of sickness, and if it be your will, heal them and restore them to full health again. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We want to pray and remember all the very kind and generous neighbours who have been good to us and who were with Charlie and his family since his diagnosis. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the staff of Abbey House Medical Centre, Mead Palliative Care and St Clair's Ward Beaumont Hospital for all their care and attention shown to Charlie in his time of illness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for a moment for our own intention. As we gather today, we think of the people in our own country, our community and indeed our world who are grieving. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God of love and mercy, give us the assurance that beyond death there is a life where broken things are mended, lost things are found, where there is rest for the weary and joy for the sad, where all that we have loved and willed of good exists, and where we will meet again our loved ones. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So now we have our offertory procession. Mary and Aisling, please. pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that Charlie may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of a blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So with the angels and saints and the hosts of heaven, we join the hymn of your glory as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Tom, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all the people.
Remember your servant Charlie, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Remember especially Charlie's parents, Michael and Bernadette, Detta, sister Kathleen, niece Deirdre Scanlon, nephew Ciaran McCabe, and brother-in-law Eamonn Corrigan, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Patrick, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver and protect us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Pray for a moment for peace. Peace in our world, but also peace in our hearts. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Just for communion, usually we don't have a roundabout system, so we'll start maybe with the row on my left, on your right, if they come up first, up and down, and then on the other side. Same on the side aisle, begin on the left and then on the right. Sarah is going to go to the galleries, so you can just hang on and there'll be communion brought to you. And then there'll be two places, at least outside, at the two doors, if you'd like to receive outside. Sorry.
Your people in my heart. wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, fill their hearts with love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord. If you lead me, I will hold your people in my heart.
First believe.
to me. His word, my hope, endures. He will, my shield and portion be. As long
I have come to the end of my journey. I have only slipped away into the next room. Whatever we were to each other, that we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak to me in the easy way which you always used. Laugh as we always did at the little jokes we enjoyed together. Play, smile, Think of me, pray for me. Let my name be the household word that it always was. Let it be spoken without effort. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same as it ever was. There is absolute continuity. Why should I be out of your mind just because I am out of sight? I am but waiting for you, for an interval, somewhere very near, just around the corner. All is well. Nothing is past. Nothing is lost. One brief moment and all will be as it was before, only better, infinitely happier, and forever we will all be one in Christ.
Let us pray. God of endless ages, from one generation to the next, you are our refuge and strength. Have mercy now on Charlie, whose life was spent in your service and the service of others. Give him a place in your kingdom where hope is firm for all who love and rest is sure for all who serve. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So thanks to all who have helped us today, those who have prepared our liturgy, the family, those who did the prayers, the processions, the reflections, and Aisling singing the reflection there. Thanks to Pazzo for the music. Thanks to everybody for gathering today and over the last number of days, and indeed all the messages that have been sent, our great support to the family, the different guards of honour from Rakenny and Senchestown, and all who made the tea and helped, all of those things that brings us together as a community to pray for Charlie and to support us in our loss. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless and protect us all now, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Charlie. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In silence, we pray for Charlie as his coffin is sprinkled with holy water as a reminder of his baptism when Christ promised him eternal life. His coffin will also be incensed as a reminder that his body is a temple of the Holy Spirit and a reminder of our prayers for Charlie rising to heaven. Thank you. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you to take you to himself, may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Charlie in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Charlie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Charlie, and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother Charlie forever. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother Charlie to his place of rest. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest.
Snow white dove, he sends his pure
sign from above, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a
Thank you.